Okay, so today we are going to do two reactions. Since I haven't done Rolling Stones or Kiss in a minute, I figured why not, kill two birds with one stone. And we have 2000 Man, and we're going to listen to it by the Rolling Stones and then the cover by Kiss. So, we're just going to get into it and talk about the songs, I guess, afterwards, after I listen to them both. So let's go. Soft voice from Jagger. Stones and 2000 Man from there. I'm just looking at some of the personnel and the year this came out. It's so 1967, and I see obviously vocals Mick Jagger, background vocalist Keith Richards, guitar mellotron, flute, soprano, saxophone, recorder, percussion, organ, Brian Jones. So that's a lot of instruments here. And I was wondering if this was after or before Jones was gone. And then we have the bass guitar, background vocalist Bill Wyman, and drums Charlie Watts, obviously, and piano, which I heard, which was a nice little touch. Organ, mellotron, harpsichord, Nicky Hopkins, and then we have the lyricists Mick Jagger and Keith Richards. So yeah, that was a nice little ditty. So I'm curious to see how Kiss takes it. And I'm looking at the comments as well on this Rolling Stones one, and apparently Ace Frehley was a big Kiss fan, or a big Kiss fan, is a big Rolling Stones fan, so I guess he hated their cover. So let's just get into Kiss's version. All right. A lot more heavy.
Yeah,
2000. All right. So, yeah, that was Kiss's version of 2000 Man. I will say off the start that what really grabbed me was Ace Frehley's vocals. I didn't, like I said, apparently he kind of headed this cover, I guess, and but I didn't know if he was going to sing vocals, but obviously he did. And you can really tell the difference between his vocals and I guess Paul Stanley's vocals or Gene Simmons' vocals and Peter Criss's vocals. But yeah, I don't know. I just really like his voice. I haven't heard too many Kiss songs. I don't know. I think I haven't heard any Kiss songs that weren't sung by Paul Stanley, as I haven't really listened to a bunch of Kiss, but that's why I'm listening to Kiss now. But yeah, Ace Frehley. I've always liked Ace Frehley anyway, even though I haven't been too much into Kiss. I like his interviews, especially when he was in Kiss, and he was kind of like, the clown of the group or whatever. He was hilarious. And yeah, I see here also on Wikipedia, it says that Frehley, he played lead guitar and bass for this song. So Gene was not playing bass for this one, and he also did lead vocals as well. And also with the lead guitar, I mean, I always just love to hear Ace Frehley's lead guitar, because I know I've seen some things about his guitar style, and it's very unconventional, I guess you could say. And yeah, so that's just, I don't know, he's just a cool cat in my book. So anyway, on genius.com, there's not much about the song 2000 Man. But there is one annotation, and there's nothing about the song. It just says for the first verse, so it says, "Well, my name is a number, a piece of plastic film, and I'm growing funny flowers in my little window sill. Don't you know I'm a 2000 man, and my kids, they just don't understand me at all." So there's an annotation here, and it says, let's just see if it's ranked well or not. It's got a couple likes, so we'll read it. Richards and Jagger begin by painting an image of a surreal future, perhaps in the year 2000, where names are numbers on pieces of plastic film and people grow funny flowers on their little window sills. And it says, "The irony in these lyrics, however, is that despite how bizarre and different the future is, the age-old concerns remain, and the protagonist complains that his children just don't understand him at all." It's also interesting to wonder, why are the flowers funny? Is it due to scientific modification, or perhaps it's just that they seem funny as organic remnants of the past in such a technologically advanced world? So yeah, flowers is a good little, I guess, example of what they're trying to say for the song, basically. And obviously the chorus, "Oh daddy, proud of your planet, oh mommy, proud of your son, oh daddy, proud of your planet, oh mommy, proud of your son." Yeah, so, and then we have the second verse, "Oh daddy, your brain's still flashing." And what I was actually getting with "your brain's still flashing," I was thinking of the Ramones, and I mean they were out about the same time as Kiss, and their version actually, well, I guess it wasn't a version, but they did a song, "Danny Says," and it really sounds like the Beach Boys to me. And this is, I don't know, it was just like I was getting that song in my head at the same time of when I was listening to these two songs. And I don't know why, but also obviously the Ramones have a song called "Your Brain Is Hanging Upside Down" or something. I can't remember the exact title, but I don't know. I was just getting a few flashes of the Ramones and the Beach Boys here. And yeah, so I don't know. There's just a lot of things flashing through my brain as well. And also, I want to say, I mean, I hesitate to say it, but I thought Kiss's version, I like Kiss's version a little better. I don't know. Obviously, Jagger's voice, I loved his softness on it and a little vulnerable sounding, you know. And but I just loved Ace Frehley's voice. I have, like I said, I've never heard his voice, and I just liked it a lot, and I like his guitar a lot, his guitar style a lot. So yeah. And also I will say, at the start of the songs, the drums stuck out to me, and I'm glad that they kind of kept that in the song or whatever, because I did notice in each song the drums were a little bit prominent at the start, which I like. So anyway, yeah, that's the Rolling Stones in Kiss 2000 Man. I liked both versions, but again, I like Kiss's a little bit better. So yeah, anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. I really appreciate all the support, and I'll talk to you guys again soon. Okay.